Hello everyone, welcome to my class. I am Hali Manisa. I am MA B.Ed and here available through the WhatsApp, and I am looking forward to the classes meeting online. Okay, hope you all are fine. Now come to the class, and in today's class we are discussing about the political science from the subject civics. What is civics? Everyone know that civics mean the study about the duties and rights of the citizens, how they have to perform towards the state and towards itself, to the society. Come to that, why the society has rejoined and why the individuals are having such type of duties to perform and such type of rules and regulations towards the state or towards the society. First topic in our subject is that meaning, nature and scope of political science. What is political science? What is the mean of that? And how it is scopeful to the today's period and to the society and to the state? And the nature of political science we will discuss. From the human society and joined together for their survival and also for the better life, hence everyone live in groups, and live in groups would be called for the understanding, for the cooperation, for the compromises, and also for the resolution of conflicts. Of course, there will be the conflicts between the group of the people. Here we can see that if individual is there, means it can run through its own thinking, through its own rules and regulation. But in society or in a state, there are the group of the peoples, those they have the different type of thinking and different type of aims and objectives to perform. So that when there are the different type of thinking, means there will be the conflicts. Of course, it's the nature. Now if any one part of the individual, such groups, therefore they framed rules, regulations and procedures for regulating the conflicts, competition and cooperations, of course there should be for the better survival and for the better development and for the better understanding to each other. Okay, that the organized way of life is called as the state, where the group of people lived state. Here, after that, the study of such organized political life is called politics or political science, where the organized group of people are living, that is the state, and about the study of organized political life is called politics, which covered subject matter or content matter. Okay, here these two terms often the identical or the synonymous terms, but they are different in meanings and scopes. Obviously, the actual process of competition, conflict and cooperation we have discussed just now, that there is a state and the group of the peoples, those who are living in an organized way of life, that is called a state. There is a state means there are the conflicts, competition, cooperation and compromises also there. So now come to that, the actual what is the meaning of the term and what is the term meant by the politics, means the study of the organized political life is called as politics. Political science is the systematic way of studying the process of politics, while the politics covers the subject matter and content matter, just to have discussed. After that, the content should be in the politics, and the science, whereas the science refers to systematic way of studying of politics. Here, the study of politics in a systematic way and in an analysis way is called as a political science. So in political science, the first term political refers to what is studied. Here politics is first referred to what is studied, and the second time science is referred to how it is studied. Second term, the science is referred to how it is studies. In short, the political is the scope of the subject, while science is the method of study. So it is called as political science. Okay, the political science is a type of science of the government of individual in an organized human society. It includes both theoretical politics and as well as the practical applied politics. The academic discipline of political science is a branch of the larger area of social sciences. Of course, if there is a society, if there is a states and governments, different type of thinkers are there, means there is a full scope of political science. Why? Because this is the only the subject which is related to other social sciences, and explain and define and systematically it defined to all the social sciences which is related to the individual, which is related to the state, and which is related to the government, how it is applied and how it is maintained and how it is practiced by an individual in human society. Okay, this is the introduction and this is the definition of the meaning and nature and the scope of science. In detail, we will discuss about the what is the scope in the society nowadays of social sciences and as well as the political sciences. Okay, and what is the actual nature of political science, how it works towards the state and how it works towards the individual and itself to the state. Now come to the nature and main meaning of the political science. After all this, let's try understand and clearly understand that a very little title of the subject is the political science. Generally, the word politics is commonly understood in applied or the practical senses, of course. But we have, most of the time, we have noticed that the politics, the word is used for the bad term and the dirty politics and the bad name. Why? Because we have said that politic word is a word of manipulating others' mind. But in actual, it is not like that. Politics is a practice and action which is taken by the government towards the individual, towards the society, towards the state to follow up in balanced way, to follow up in a good manner, to develop the society, to develop state for the welfare of a state. But commonly, just when we heard the politic word, what you will think? If anyone playing a games and manipulating the other's mind, directly we will said that, oh, what a politics you have played. Okay, so that don't take the politic in a negative way. It is a positive word, that politics, and it is applied or in a practical senses. Okay, in fact, the word politics does not have a bad name. But what is politics then? Means what is the difference between the politics and the political science, we will see now. To better understand the politics and the political science, that the terminology has defined these two terms in a very different ways, including the state, including the individual, and including as well as the government and the governments of other countries also. So we will see that how it is defined and in what way it is defined as the politics and as well as the political science. Okay. Now we will see the word politics is derived from the ancient Greek word, that is polis, means it covers, it defines the state and the city or the city. And the word from the polity is a politia, means the government or the constitution. So the politics come to mean the study of state and government and the institutions of the state. In the classical Greek sense, politics and the political sciences are covered both the aspects of theoretical understanding and as well as the practical affairs of the state. Now, in general agreements among the political thinkers of the meaning and the definition of political science is different. The definitions of political science can be broadly divided into two, that is traditional and modern. The traditional writers considered the study of state and government as the proper sphere of political science. means they have defined that the sphere of political science is properly study of state and government, and the state and government both are closely related. Of course, there is a state means there should be the government. If there is no state means there is no government. Here, there can be no state without government, obviously. The state and the government has been the central subject of the study of political science. After all these things, the whole thing is that the political science means the study of politics, which is related to state and the government. And state and government both are interrelated to each other. Okay. Without state, there is no government. And without government, there should be no proper state or no balanced state. So that's why where there is a state, it should be there the good government for to frame out and the structure out the good formation of that society or of that state. Okay. Now after the Second World War, in the period of Second World War, the political scientists in the West developed new theories and developed the new concepts and the disciplines towards the political sciences. American scientist, those who has defined the political science is 1930s, is that the political science is the study of power, because the state is the structure of power and the business of the political scientist to examine who gets the power, when and how. During the 20s years, in 1950, the school thinkers shifted the emphasis and the studies of political sciences to the other definition. The thinkers and the scholars has redefined and reconcept and word political science as a policy making science. Whether before the World War II in 1930s or 1950s, that has defined as the power of state. After that period, the thinkers and the scholars of political science has redefined the political science as a policy making science. Why? Because it is changing by time to time, and it is changing most of the changes in the society and as well as in the rules and regulations of government also. So, the modern writers has expanded the scope of political science. They describe the political science as the science of the study of power, of course, or the policy making sciences. Here, the fundamental activity in every organized group of human life should be and have to be followed the rules and regulations to balance the society and to balance the state. So that here the political sciences having the more and more scope of the political science in the modern times. Broadly speaking, the study of political science has developed into two standards, that is normative and the empirical. Now come to the normative. What is normative means? The normative study of political science is main focus on norms, values, goals and end of the political life activity, but most of the studies of the concepts such as liberty, equality, justice and empowerment and the state of ideology are covered under the normative studies. It has a strong view on the norms, values and what are the end of the political activities and end of the political life, empowerment, how they are covering and how they are maintaining and how they are working towards the state and towards the government of individuals. All these things are come under the normative political science. Okay, now it also that the empirical studies has both the sides, quantitative and qualitative, and focus on the facts and the actual process and meaning that subscribe of the achievement of goals. What have done, what we have achieved, what are the goals and objectives of the political science, how it is worked and how it is applied and how it is implementing all these things. It is focused on the qualitative and as well as the quantitative, for the main focus is that on facts and the actual process that which have applied and what are the achievements of a goals. All these things come under the empirical type of political science. Empirical means based on pure logic, what are the main thing to do all these things. The study of the functioning of government and the other institutions and the human instructions and the human interactions and in a different capacities come under the empirical studies. This includes the studies on public policies, voting behavior, political parties, pressure groups and social movements. All these things are come under the empirical. Why? Because it focus on facts and the actual process which is applied. Okay. Now, as we have earlier discussed that the political sciences having the traditional and the modern definitions. Now, some great thinkers of political sciences has defined the political science in their own words. We will see. Namely, the classical or traditional are the same things, and the modern definitions we have discussed that they have defined the political science into two parts, that is modern and traditional. Traditional definitions by the great thinkers of political sciences. First, J.W. Garner, what he said that political science begins and ends with the state. He defined political science that the political science begins and ends with the state only. State, we know that what is state? The group of the organized life is as state, okay, human society. Next is the great thinker is that the Paul James, he defined the political science is the part of a social sciences which treats of the foundation of the state and the principle of the government. Now, he defining the political science that the political science is a part of social sciences and it is the foundation of a state and the principle of the government. Obviously, it is correct by the thinkers of the political science, and the different type of thinkers have defined the political science in different ways. But the main thing is that all of them have political sciences is based on the state and government only, and the state of power and the state of government and the state of society, all these things are only discussed but in a different ways. Now come to the third great thinker, that is R.J. Jatil. He described and he defined the political science like political science is the historical investigation of the state in the past and analytical study of the state at present and the what the state ought to be in the future. He defined this. It is absolutely correct. The political science is the subject which define the study of politics, which define the study of state, which define the study of government, which is from the history and now in the present, and it is planning to what to be the state in the future. It is only about this. So he describing that the political science nothing but it is the historical investigation. Of course, when we have studied about the history of government, about the history of constitutions, about the history of states and societies, we get the more of the things that we have changed it nowadays. Now, in the an analytical study of the state at present, analytical means obviously if the study of anything, of any subject, that we have to study it in a systematic way to find the actual meaning, to find that how it is working and why it is working, the what the changes have to done in this, all these things will be come out after the analytical studies only. So that he defined this political science is an analytical study of the state at present, and the political science is the state out that what would be the state in future. Of course, if we are doing something means we have some objectives and we have some aims what we are doing now. Now, what are the goals of these activities? what we will take from this and how it is very valuable for the future. All these things will be first in our mind of doing anything. But whereas come to the government and come to the state means it is the first thing that they have to understand what we have done in history, now what we are doing and how it is worked in future. Okay. So these things he has explained and defined as a political science to the society. Come to the next great thinker, that is Howard Laswell and Kaplan, that both of them has defined the political science in a same way. What is that? That is, politics is an empirical inquiry in the study of shaping and sharing of power. Absolutely. If there is an inquiry, empirical means the quantitative and qualitative activities, practical activities which is implemented, we have already discussed. Now, it is inquiry is the study of shaping and sharing the power. Whereas we are shaping a state, shaping a government, there will be the more chances to sharing of power with the others. Okay. Here, both of them are defining the political science as the shaping and sharing of the power and the empirical inquiry. Get it? Now come to the next great thinker of political science is that Robert De Haal. What he is saying? He is defining the political science as political science is a scientific study of importance of power, authority and influence. Absolutely. Whole thing is including the power, whole thing is including the authority, and the whole subject of political science is influence to others. He is saying that the political science is nothing but it is the study of importance. It is the study of importance of power. It is the study of importance of authority. It is the study of importance of influence, how they working, how the power is going, how the power is changing, and how the authority of being and how they are influencing all these things, how the political works, how the political affairs, how the political activities, how the all these things are doing through the political science. Only the political science which is studies through the scientists towards the political science of importance of power, authority and influence. He describing the political science in his words. After Robert De Haal, the great thinker of political science is that David Stern. What he is defining the political science in his words that political science is related with the different activities highly influencing the system of power that directs to the society and the method of implementing the power and the social values controlled and directed officially. Here he is saying that the political science is a subject and political science is a studies that influencing the system of power and directing the society means here the rules and regulations and the framework and the structuring of the society is that directing to the society and the implementing of power through the state, through the government, to the society and the social values controlled and directed officially. Here means the rules and regulations which are regulating, which are implementing and applying on the individual in the human society is controlled by the officially. How they are maintaining, how they are exercising the rules and regulations and how they are using the powers towards the society and towards the individual and how it is working to the state and how it is working to the government. All these things come under the political sciences only. He defining all these things as a theoretical and as the practical aspects of the political science.